It's Tampa Bay Bucks Super Bowl 55 champ Shaq Barrett coming at you live for NSPN NexGen Sports. Go like and follow NSPN for total coverage of all team and combat sports, live shows, plus exclusive player interviews and unprecedented sports content creation.
Medical marijuana made easy. See if you pre-qualify for your Florida medical marijuana card free of charge, 100% risk, obligation, and judgment free. With Fast Track Cannabis Clinics of America. You're talking Tampa Bay's number one choice for compassionate care with business professionals. Discreetly begin your road to relief by dialing 813-358-CARD or visit www.mycannabiscard.com. That's 813-358-2273. And make sure to tell them that Al Tech sent you for $30 off new patient enrollment. Ask about military and senior discounts. Fast Track Cannabis Clinics of America. Launch or scale your brand or business with Guerrilla Marketing, Inc. and digitally dominate the competition. Right now, get a small business starter package. You're talking a custom logo, toll-free vanity number, equipped with a digital directory, five-page website, and matching media page for $1,299. That's a $3,000 value. Visit GuerrillaMarketingInc.com or call 813-358-2273 to get started. With uncertainty at an all-time high, securing what matters most has never been more important for your home or your office. Prevent disaster and make life easier. Try a security and home automation system from Alarm Engineers, Inc., Tampa's trusted leader for more than 30 years. State-of-the-art security systems, award-winning monitoring, and now full-spectrum smart home solutions. Alarm Engineers, Inc. has everything your home and office could possibly need and will work with any budget. Book a free security or smart home consultation today. Call 813-948-4000. That's 813-948-4000. And get your first month free by telling them Al Keck sent you. Alarm Engineers, Inc. Sports media has evolved. Introducing NSPN, NexGen Sports. Your number one choice for total coverage of all team and combat sports. Up-to-the-minute breaking news, live shows with special guests, and unprecedented interactive sports content. Go like and follow NSPN Next Gen Sports on Facebook for your chance to win an authentic autographed Shaq Barrett Bucks jersey. That's valued at more than $1,000. Do it today. The winner will be picked live on May 18th on our NSPN Next Gen Sports Facebook page. Next Gen Sports.
What's up, everybody, and welcome back to another edition of Sports Talk 49 live and exclusively on NSPN Next Gen Sports. I just wanted to give you guys a quick 30, 25 minutes to talk about some things. Aaron Rodgers is something I'm going to save for another conversation because I would rather have some reaction, you know, somebody going back and forth with me. talking about that. But today I just wanted to talk about one of the Buccaneers draft picks. And then we're going to talk about Cam Jordan's comments. Really, Cam Jordan. Anyway, I'm Blake Anthony. This is Sports Talk 49, giving you a late edition. Well, late for me because you know I'm usually daytime. But let me get straight into it. Tampa Bay Buccaneers decided to move up in the fourth round and select speedy, shifty, Tariq Cohen as a wide receiver, and Jaelon Darden, North Texas wideout. Now, why did they make this pick? For several reasons. If you really know the roster and know players' intangibles, then that meaning things that they can and can't do and things that they do well, Jaelon Darden would fit the bill. Antonio Brown was an intricate piece. Why? You could throw screens to him. He makes plays off the line of scrimmage, catching passes, running the ball. He offers an elusiveness part in your offense that other people don't provide. Yes, Mike Evans can get away from some people. Yes, Chris Godwin can get away from some people. But that's not really their skill set to move off of screens and things like that. They're big physical guys. So they're good at what they do, but Jaelon Darden can learn that from Antonio Brown. So I decided to take the time out of my schedule and make a nice My Perspective video, what I usually do during the season, but I'm going to bring those to you on some of these draft picks. I'm going to do another one on the offensive lineman that the Jicks took out of Notre Dame. So look forward to seeing that. And looking forward, if you like premium content, make sure to subscribe to NSPN NexGen right on YouTube, Facebook, and follow me at Blake Anthony on Twitter and Instagram. So without further ado, let me just go right into the video. Check out Jaelon Darden. Tell me what you think. Again, click like and subscribe and share with your friends as I pull up the video for you.
Making someone miss is like waking up in the morning and brush my teeth. I got to do it every day.
Everybody's going to ask Jaelon Darden out of North Texas, what's it like to be working with Chris Godwin and Mike Evans? The real question should be, what is it like working with Antonio Brown? Because I see so many similarities with the ability to make people miss in space, creating separation, and turning screens into big gains for touchdowns and first downs. I'm really interested to see what Jaelon does in Bruce Arians' offense and getting acclimated into this new system with a new team. So I'm really looking forward to seeing how this offseason goes for him. Let's go into details on my perspective on Antonio Brown comparison to Jaelon Darden. Here you see Antonio Brown is in space, defenders locked up on the outside receiver, and the safety is far off of the slot receiver, which is Antonio Brown. Tom Brady sees that, checks to it, gets the ball out to Brown in space. He knows the safety, Keanu Neal cannot get to him, breaks the first tackle, and gets into better scoring position. Here's my example of why Jaelon Darden is compared to Antonio Brown. Same scenario here. In the red zone, safety's too far off, outside corners playing press on the outside receiver. Quarterback has the wits to throw this ball into the flats. Jaelon beats the first defender and is able to get in the end zone. When you give a guy with this kind of speed and this kind of quickness, I guess they called it twitch and escapability, it's nearly impossible to stop him with one-on-one in open field. And he is very compared to Antonio Brown as far as size and speed. Jaelon ran a 4.46, Antonio Brown ran a 4.47. So they're very compared to each other in a lot of ways than one, and I expect Jaelon to be joined at the hip with Antonio Brown this offseason. Thanks for watching, and make sure to subscribe to us on NSPN, Next Gen Sports on YouTube, Next Gen NSPN Sports on Facebook, as well as follow me on BlakeAnthony49 on Instagram and Twitter. Couldn't have said it better myself. I'm Blake Anthony, Sports Talk 49. Give me my perspective on Jaelon Darden and why picking him up in the fourth round was so important, because without Antonio Brown, you lose an aspect in their offense that Scotty Miller doesn't provide. Scotty Miller is a great straight line speed guy, which that's why I ran the 100 in college. He's a world-class sprinter. But agility and elusiveness really isn't his forte. So that's why you pick up guys like that. Those are guys that are in one-on-one situations. They're going to, if they're even, they're leaving. And he offers that ability just like Antonio Brown. And they could take it to the house once they get around it. Now, he's much faster on tape than he did running his 40 time, as I pointed out in the video. Antonio Brown ran a 4.46. Jaelon Darden ran a 4.47. Jaelon Darden ran a 4.46. Sorry, corrected that. So he can learn from Antonio Brown. So Brown's not going to be around forever. He might want to go to Baltimore next year and play with his cousin. Or, you know, before you ride out, try to make as much money as you can. Try to get these Super Bowls while the getting is good. And while he's gone doing whatever it is he wants to do, now you're left with Jaelon Darden, who could fit the bill, learn the system. Very smart guy, very determined, was raised by his father, is motivated by the death of his father, his passing of his father. And yet a guy who loves the game and wants to be better than what he thinks, you know, be better than what everybody thinks he is, small, undersized and things like that. But the NFL has shown you intangibles can't be measured when you look on tape. Some of these things come from inside. And those are the guys you want to put on your roster. Those are the guys you want leading your football team when you go out to battle and try to win these big games in the division NFC South with the new regime Panthers, Atlanta Falcons, and the New Orleans Saints fixing themselves up and things like that. But those are the kind of guys you got to build, and you got to start building for the future. As you saw, Tampa Bay also picked up a quarterback in Kyle Trask, which is, you know, by Florida people, you know, it's either you got Gator fans or Florida State fans or USF or UCF fans. So a lot of people have different feelings on that draft pick. But, I mean, what should matter is that he's not in college anymore. He is now in the pros, and he's considered a professional player, and he should handle himself as such. So back to what I was saying about Jaelon Darden, I think that's why that pick was there, because you didn't know what you were going to do if Antonio goes out injured. He decides to leave next year, you know, but now you have a guy that does have kick returning ability. Everybody's first initial thought was Jaelon Darden was just going to be a kick return specialist. Yes, he's going to play special teams, as a lot of the other players will, because that's how you have to make this team. You have to do your part on this team, and playing special teams is part of it. But to think that he's just exclusively just kick returning slash punt returning is a little ill-advised. And I think he will be, at some point, he'll come in and play just like Tyler Johnson, just like Cameron Bray took a restructure, Tanner Hudson. You got a lot of a plethora of players, quality depth coming from your bench now. And Jaelon Darden is just another addition to that. And if he could provide some returning availability, not sure what's going on with Jadon Mickens, with his legal situation and all that stuff. So a lot of these things could be put in place because of something else. So you kind of got to let it play out and see what happens. But I just wanted you guys to get a great look at what's going on with Jaelon Darden and how he fits with this new regime, Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And if you missed the video, you can rewatch this, or just go to NSPN, NexGen Sports, and you can watch the my perspective of what I just put out on Jaelon Darden in comparison to Antonio Brown. That being said, let's move on to the next topic. Cam Jordan. Like I said, I want to give you guys a great segment right here. I want to talk about these things. Cam Jordan, the biggest mouth in the NFC South. I think somebody said it best that Cam Jordan cared more about being the man of the South rather than being a Super Bowl champion. I think that's accurate, because he constantly wanted to take shots at people and things like that. Meanwhile, his team is lackluster in postseason performance and didn't show up big himself. Tristan Wirfs had a nice game against him, as well as Donovan Smith. So let me just let you hear what he said, and then we'll talk a little bit more about it. Then I'll get out of here. Christopher Cole, Darden, a.k.a. Darden equals A.B., Tyler Johnson, Chris Godwin. Now we need a player to equal Evans. Good luck finding someone to equal Evans, right? I mean, it's not about equaling. And Chris, it's not about equaling. It's about what player, like what aspect do you add to the wide receiver core? You can't have all of the same wide receivers. It just doesn't work because you don't know what kind of matchups you get on your defense against defenses, or corners being so tall or some being fast and things like that. See, Mike's not fast, super fast, but he's tall and physical. But he's not going to beat you with expert route running, one-on-ones, making the first defender miss, those type of things Mike can't offer. But he offers a lot of other things. That's why you need different skill sets, especially at wide receiver and running back position. You got to have people that can either all well-rounded. Yeah, it's good to have a plethora of players. It's not really about equaling somebody. It's about having that measurable on your roster when the call of duty calls, when you need that player to make a certain defender or a certain coverage mess up. That's what I believe it is, Chris. Skill sets. Yes, that's what it is. It's not about equaling somebody. It's about what are you bringing to the team? What measurable? That's what it's about. And he brings an aspect to the team that we don't have. The Tampa Bay Buccaneers don't have. They do have it in Brown. He's just much older. But I think he should be joined to the hip with him and learning the ins and outs and how to be a great route runner. I just hope I could explain that good enough. But let's get back to the Cam Jordan thing. Check this out and let me know what you comment on it.
Apparently, one of their divisional rivals wants to chime in. Cam Jordan, your thoughts on Kyle Pitts at 4?
I mean, come on. You know Atlanta's on the clock. I'm over there looking like, yeah, who's going to be lining up against you? I love it. He's a little light in the ass to be a tight end. But when you think about, you know, what he's doing as a receiver type, I mean, he's doing everything. I mean, you think about, you know, maybe the only tight end we saw this last season that's sort of comparable was Darren Waller. In my mind, I sort of treat him like Jimmy Graham, like one of those tall guys can go up and get it, which is going to pose a problem for most teams. I mean, luckily we got Demario Davis, and I think that says enough. But when you think about, you know, that pick, Terry's out there, you know, making bold moves. I can't do nothing but be excited for the matchup that we will have to come, as long as he's detached from the line and not attached to the line, because then I have to detach him from his body.
Yes, my silence. Always something smart to say. Meanwhile, he sits there another year. No Super Bowl. The NFC South champ. He does have that. He's got that. He plays defensive line. Kyle Pitts plays tight end. You'll never guard him. I mean, he's going to be down there and maybe chip block you or something. I think the guy's just a little bit too full of himself sometimes. Yes, I think he's possibly a Hall of Fame defensive end. I think so. Cam Jordan. I think he's made a lot of plays his entire career. But this one, I just think you need to just shut the hell up. Shut the hell up. You talk so damn much and have done so little in aspects as a team aspect. Now, if you want to talk about individuality, you've made monumental steps and strides that I'll give nothing but respect for. But now if we're talking about team, you just need to shut the hell up. You're going to be detaching anybody from your body. First of all, you're a guy in his later half of his career, still playing very well. Like I said, you haven't won a Super Bowl in a very long time. I can't remember if he was on the roster or not when the Saints got that Super Bowl. I think he's more content with being champions of the NFC South versus being Super Bowl champs or the champ of running his mouth the most and things like that. I think he cares more about that than actually getting on there. I mean, worrying about winning a Super Bowl, because he was nowhere to be found when Tampa Bay went up to New Orleans and beat them and went on to move on to win the Super Bowl. He was nowhere to be found. Atlanta takes a pick. Atlanta's in a rebuilding process with their team. They got a lot of different things going on. and they would decide that they draft a tight end. And you feel like you got a bunch of opinions. You're talking about you're watching the draft to see who's getting picked up and things like that. Don't you think that's like billboard material? Like when you say stupid crap like that, Cameron? I just think it's just stupid sometimes. Sometimes you just need to shut the hell up. Like, seriously, it's just like we know you can play. We know you're good. But clearly you don't make enough impact in games that your team can get over the hump and win a Super Bowl. If you want to blame Breeze, you want to blame whoever. But if you take most of the credit, you got to take most of the blame, too. And this team has fell short on many occasions, two times to the Minnesota Vikings. one of them in an immeasurable fashion that we'll never forget, just the whiff of missing the hit on Stephon Diggs to just another playoff loss with Kyle Rudolph mossing them in the end zone, controversial offensive pass interference, whatever it is. It just seems like there's always something that team always falls short for, and they're great regular season champs, but they're playoff chumps. They're pretty much playoff chumps, and they're regular season champs. So when you look at the Saints, you think of this. You'd be like,
my mind's telling me no.
Mm-hmm. Then they got to the playoffs, and do you think they're going to make a – they're going to do well and all that?
My body's telling me yes.
Mine ain't telling me yes. It's telling me – they're telling me no, that the Saints are just regular season champs, playoff chumps. And their drafts didn't really – they didn't shock me unless these guys are really studs. I have no idea what they're going to do. Jameis Winston, Taysom Hill. I believe they drafted another quarterback as well. Ian Brooks out of Notre Dame. It just really surprised me that Cam Jordan really had the audacity to get on there and talk about, you know, detach their heads from their body, talking about Kyle Pitts and like somebody's supposed to be scared of you. Whatever. It is what it is. It's free will. These guys can come out and talk and say whatever you want. They're grown men. They got social medias. They got each other's numbers. It's a union for these players. But I just wanted to talk about Jaelon Darden in comparison to Antonio Brown. And I wanted to talk about Cam Jordan's comments to the drafting of Kyle Pitts in Atlanta. And I'm going to leave you with that. And I want to get out of here. And I'll see if I go live with you guys tomorrow or a couple days. And we'll talk about some more of the issues like with Aaron Rodgers and things like that. Because there's a lot going on in this league. And just needs to be addressed. And then the NBA, LeBron's comments and all that. So that'd be a long conversation. I'd rather have that with you another time where I can get some of you guys' reaction, phone calls, and things like that, and we could talk about it. But for today, you guys think about what I said about Jaelon Darden. Think about what we talked about with Cam Jordan. What do you guys think about that? What do you think about Jaelon Darden, I think, being joined at the hip with Antonio Brown? All that here and more right on here on NSPN Next Gen Sports. I'm Blake Anthony, host of Sports Talk 49. Appreciate you guys watching. Make sure to follow me, like, subscribe me, BlakeAnthony49, as well as do that, the NSPN Next Gen Sports. I'll see you guys again soon, and we'll end this as we always do. You're the master of everything that you do with your life. What you do with it is entirely up to you. Thank you, guys. God bless, and as always, fire those cannons.
It's Tampa Bay Bucks Super Bowl 55 champ Shaq Barrett coming at you live for NSPN Next Gen Sports. Go like and follow NSPN for total coverage of all team and combat sports, live shows plus exclusive player interviews and unprecedented sports content creation.